two uninhabited Pacific islands. More than 5,000 miles from the UK.
One will be inhabited by 14 British men.
Go, go, go!
While a separate island will be home to 14 British women. For 6 weeks, they'll be utterly alone.
Holy shit!
With only the clothes they stand up in.
Yeah!
And a handful of basic tools. Filming everything themselves.
When pushed to the limits of human endurance.
Will it be brute power? Or mental strength that wins the day?
Yes!
Put him!
Who will
have what it takes to stay alive?
Tonight, we follow the women's island.
Jeez!
That was so weak.
Survival will be harder than ever. The search for water and the hunt for food is now a matter of life or death. Living on the island in the middle of tropical storm season.
It's really hard.
When pitted against the extremes of nature, have these modern day women got what it takes to survive?
Your bodies are just starting to fail. I'm right on the brink of pulling you all off the island for medical reasons, over.
Women remain of the 14 I dropped off on this remote Pacific island.
You are not leaving this island. I don't care if I have to carry you on my back.
As they approach the four-week mark, they're entering a new and potentially dangerous phase of the experiment.
I just don't find starvation a sexy way to get skinny.
Without enough food and water, their bodies could be in serious danger of shutting down.
I think it's about time that we get out there and
get a bit brutal.
Yesterday, the women finally managed to trap their first big prey.
Yeah, it's massive.
And ate their biggest meal yet.
Anybody watches this and judges any of the girls here for what they've done today, they can f*** off.
It's day 26.
What's that? It's moving.
It's really big. I knew there was things here.
Yeah,
I tried to put it into your skin.
Don't
worry about it. Let me just get it out.
A plague of parasites from yesterday's pig carcass has hit camp.
Basically, camp is infested with ticks.
Oh, Christ.
Let's wash down and we'll basically give each other a visual check.
Who says we don't have to take our clothes off to have a good time?
Hello! She looks a bit angry.
It was angry, bit me.
Turns out I've had a tick right on my bum. It's made a right mess. Oh, it didn't offer.
I've got one there, but like it's got its head in there.
These blood-sucking insects burrow their heads deep under the skin to feed, exposing the women to a host of dangerous tropical diseases.
I also went like that with my fingernail. The arse end of this tick came up with its legs moving. Wow. God, it knocked me sick. I think it's piggy's revenge.
Despite their recent pig kill,
the women now have been living on an extreme low-calorie diet
with very little water for the past 4 weeks. From here, there's barely any research about the effects of extreme survival on the body.
And because of this, they're now entering dangerous medical territory.
Without an adequate and constant supply of food and water,
they're going to risk long-term damage to their vital organs, and they don't want that.
Like that?
Yeah. It caught the pig.
We cooked it as well, and now we're staying up all night to preserve it in salt water from the sea so that everybody can eat meat for the next 3 days.
Hunters Lauren and Beth, along with Havila and Becky, are working through the night to ensure they make the most of yesterday's pig kill.
Oh, no, most of the wicked girl.
Hey, that's island life.
While they're doing that, we are going to dig a hole in the ground to bury the jerry can. So it's going to be a bit like a fridge, but a fridge for, like, cavemen.
With temperatures in excess of 30 degrees, the coolest place to store the meat is underground.
Let's get it as deep as we can.
To do this, Lauren and Beth have requisitioned one of the women's two jerrycans, which up to this point has been used to filter, boil and store their drinking water.
I'm kind of not happy about that.
Which is a cause of concern for lifelong vegetarian Jamie.
I know it's quite a big deal, but it's also quite a big deal for me drinking water. There's no way I'm drinking out of that.
It's got to be done. People must be fed.
A bit devastated about still being awake at this time in the morning. This is not the same as tottering in at 5 a.m. on a pair of heels, really, really drunk.
Having worked through the night, the pig preservers head back to camp with the jerry can filled with pork.
I think people have their priorities wrong. I'm not saying that they shouldn't have done that to preserve the pig, because I also didn't want the pig to go to waste. I mean, I know I'm a vegetarian, so it's easy for me to say, but it's almost like that was prioritised over our water, and that's what I'm pissed off about.
OK, we're just going to cover this valve, because we don't want any little nasties.
On the island, Jamie's helped establish a successful water purification system, using one jerry can for filtering and the other jerry can as a kettle for boiling.
It's whole water system. I've been sitting there for days doing it. One jerry can, get it on the boil, filter out the other jerry can, get that on the boil. And even then we're struggling with the water. Now we've got one shitty jerry can without a lid. So now I'm suffering.
Midday. With tonight's dinner stored in their makeshift fridge, the women who stayed up preserving the pig are resting on the beach.
You smell so clean.
I'm just missing you.
55-year-old Julie is hard at work, determined to supplement the women's dinner.
She spotted a dead fish.
But what I'm going to do is, I'm going to tie this up and tie it to my ankle and see if anything else comes to eat it that I can scoop up in my kiddie net. What a lack in talent I make up for in enthusiasm. My mum used to say that.
Oh, Julie.
862 altogether. I'm single, divorced. I've bought the house. This is my second house that I've bought. And I've done it all on my own. I think I'm hard working. Once I start, I'll really give it, you know, till I'm absolutely dropping. So it's like I'm behind myself with a big stick all the time. I don't give myself a break.
Just be careful, I don't want a shark taking your leg off. This is the strangest fishing I've ever seen.
Julie is killing me. I absolutely love her.
I'll keep throwing it out like a distressed fish.
I don't know anything about fishing.
I could be a couple of hours. I'll give you the shout.
Oh, Julie.
Further down the beach...
Give me a really good tongue towards you.
Jamie's made a discovery that could make her water more palatable.
That is lime leaves, isn't it?
Yeah. I've been picking heaps and heaps of these lime leaves and putting it in this boiled water. It just takes away some of that rotten taste. Mm.
Totally tropical taste.
I'm fucking determined we're going to get something out of this ocean.
On the shoreline, Julie is still hard at it.
No, she didn't! Yeah!
Good, Julie!
Wow. No, she just
lost it! Fish fell back in the water. I just fucking despair, I do, honest to God.
2 p.m. Julie is still fishing.
Have you ever seen anyone fish like that before in your life?
I don't think any fish could have gone here.
Whilst the rest of the women are more interested in sunbathing and relaxing on the beach.
This is why we came here. This bay is an absolute dream, isn't it?
Exhausted.
Beth and Lauren wake to discover none of the other women have done any work.
We stayed up. We cooked breakfast for everybody, we cooked supper for everybody, and then we needed a kind of a little bit of a break today, and because we've had a break, everybody else has had a fucking break, and nothing's happened. Do you know what? Sometimes I find this island sends me round the fucking bend.
Everyone was agreeing, you know, you guys need to have a bit more of a chill day. Well, everyone seems to have taken that as everybody's going to have a relaxation. So we're back at 4 o'clock in the evening. There's no wood for the fire. Just feel like everyone's taking the piss, really.
So infuriating. I mean, in a minute, Lauren and I are going to start cooking again. On the preserved meat, and I guarantee you, people that have been doing fuck all day are going to be sitting front row and going, oh, yum, 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 eating all the big bits. And that is just winding my fucking bobbin up. Oh my God. That smells funky, doesn't it?
Lauren and Beth have dug up the jerry can of preserved meat.
I mean, that jerry can does smell of fucking vomit, though, doesn't it?
I think it's borderline. It goes off very quickly, doesn't it?
With no other food collected during the day, the women risk eating the suspect pork.
Come and grab a coconut bowl and fill up.
What do you think, girls?
Doesn't taste right, does it?
Makes you feel a bit ill.
It is absolutely disgusting.
Like, tastes gross. Disgusting. But, you know, when it's the only thing you've got to eat...
The pork may have been foul, but at least Jamie's flavoured lime water has hit the spot.
Oh, my God, Jamie, it's so good.
Oh, my God, it's amazing. That was really exciting.
That's the best thing ever.
Oh!
That's almost better than cunnilingus.
I don't like them being down there.
What?
I get scared. I don't... Like, what the fuck are they doing? And their little beady eyes. Don't like it. Don't like it at all. I'm like, get up, get up.
Oh, my God.
Excuse the farting.
That fucking smell.
I know, it's awful.
Last night, the women ate the rancid preserved pork, but it's backfired on them this morning.
God, that was awful. I'm going to have to go.
Oh, no, sorry. You're not going to be sick,
are you? I don't know. I don't feel very well. Sorry!
Basically shitting myself, and I have no idea when it's going to happen, and I have 30 seconds to go. Basically, then what happens is that you have explosive water, diarrhoea coming out of you.
Twice now I haven't been able to make it, and I've had to bring back like my soiled pants and wash them.
Harvey, can you take this? I'll take the head. Can you take the white thing for me?
With the preserved pork no longer edible, the women remove the pig's remains and jerry can of putrid meat from the camp.
It's rancid.
Is the head in here?
Rotting head. Fucking tick. I think we just ditch all of this shit.
Yeah, none of it's coming back.
We don't need that canister, we don't need any of this. I don't need this in my life right now.
Unconvinced they could salvage a rancid jerry can and use it to purify the water again, the women throw it away.
Sorry, the eyes are sort of popping out.
I've learned from experience that big disasters are often made up of quite small mistakes, but they have consequences and it sets off like a chain reaction. And that chain can be very hard to break.
Now with only one jerry can to produce all their water, the women are unknowingly heading towards a dehydration crisis.
We've lost half our buckets and half our containers now.
Yes.
But we'll find more buckets and containers, but we couldn't possibly have brought those back. I mean, they were just rack.
In one stroke, the women have halved the amount of drinking water they can produce and have permanently disrupted their purification system. Vegetarian Jamie is unimpressed.
I'm not happy. That's how much water I've got left. I had that in this morning, so that's all I've drank today. I'm pissed off at the fucking situation. And I think I've got PMT.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Four weeks in, and the women are entering uncharted survival territory.
It's fucking hard. Like, it's not a joke. It's really hard. And I miss everybody. I miss my family so much, and I miss my boyfriend so much, and my best friend so much. And all I want to do is, you know, have something substantial to eat or have some water that doesn't taste like the bottom of a swamp. But I just keep telling myself I have to keep pushing on.
The women have unwittingly put themselves at risk of dehydration after discarding a contaminated jerry can. It means they can now only boil and purify half the amount of drinking water.
When that happened yesterday, I was like,
yeah, she lost it. Don't ask for much, do you? Coconut support.
Exactly.
Jamie is furious with the other women and decides to take drastic action.
Really annoyed, actually.
I'm going on strike now.
I'm going to do what I want. When I want.
I'm not doing anything else apart from the water.
Because I cannot live without water.
Rolling!
Jamie has withdrawn her labour from the group and will now only do the one job that benefits her, collecting and purifying the water.
I'm going to be water bitch. Because nobody else gets a shit. No. I don't understand. Where do you think it fucking comes from? Yeah. A tap!
I work on my own now, so it's quite fun not having anybody to tell me what to do. I don't really like anybody bossing me about. On the island, ideally, I would really like a fun bunch of girls. Anyone that took themselves too seriously, I would find that a bit difficult.
It's just a never-ending circle of chores to be done.
In camp, the women are working through their long list of daily jobs.
We have basic chores that have to be done on a daily basis or else we won't survive. Getting wood for the fire, getting water and finding food. And if we don't succeed in those, everything goes to hell in a handcart.
After this,
yeah.
I'm going to filter water and then I'm going to have a bath, brush yeah. my teeth, wash my clothes, chill out.
Surviving takes hard graft and everyone working together as a community. You've got to do all you can to keep a group cohesive and together, because when it's together, it's strong. It's not strong when it's fragmented and broken.
Definitely have more water than you.
You bet.
You chucked it up!
No,
you chucked the bag up!
You should have seen mine!
The water wanderer's return.
Jamie starts purifying the water. It's a process that takes up to 3 hours, but will now only produce one can's worth of water to drink.
Feel like I'm in a faint.
Julie and Havila have moved on to their next job of the day, collecting firewood.
Is that hard work, girls?
So hard work.
Yeah, I'll have to sit down. Down all the drains.
Right.
My mum had an expression, and it's very true. Only willing horses get worked to death.
My mum used to say that.
Dead now. She was worked to death.
She was.
You've got some colour, Janie!
Good. Oh, I'm ready to spot it again.
2 p.m. While the other women remain hard at work, Jamie is relaxing on the beach, and it hasn't gone unnoticed.
I feel like I haven't stopped today. Like, it's one job after the other. It's how it is. Being here, you've just got to be so busy. Got to work as a team as well.
I know.
So I struggle to understand how some people function on just doing one thing a day.
Hey, Tits McGee!
Who the fuck thought?
Jamie again, sunbathing on the beach. There is a large handful of us that work solidly the whole time. Not for ourselves, though, for the whole team, so the whole team can benefit from it.
I'm naked here. Stop filming me.
And Not everyone has that same level of responsibility, and it's a joke. Jamie is so annoying.
If she hadn't have gone and got water, then she'd have done absolutely nothing for the whole day.
Especially because there's so much to do right now.
It just made me really frustrated and angry, kind of a little bit like, where's the fucking team spirit gone, man?
Right, meeting!
Something has to be said because I was getting fucked off. We are a small group now, there's only 10 of us, and so we need everybody to be hands on deck, and that isn't happening.
It's becoming really obvious, like, that certain people are doing lots of things, and sometimes I do feel like some people aren't doing as much. Everybody is knackered, everybody is depleted of energy. In a way, get over that and accept that everyone has to pull their weight. Does everyone feel like they are contributing the same?
That's what I would.
Well, I do.
I do, yeah, actually.
I don't like sitting here and people are making out as if some people are being lazy in the camp and not pulling their weight.
It's not just a one-job day.
Yeah,
this is my thing.
Not.
That, you know, stuck. The jobs continue.
There's certain jobs that I don't feel that I actually need to partake in.
What do you mean by that? What do you mean
yeah,
by that?
I can help with things that will benefit me. That means anything to do with water. But things that won't benefit me, no, I don't care.
Just crazy, crazy talk. It's just the lack of acknowledgement that, in fact, they weren't pulling their weight. How can you be so selfish? How can you not give a shit about anybody else? I mean, it's just complete bullshit.
I don't like getting told what to do and when to do it. So if I want to lie down and zombies for an hour, everybody else can fuck off.
Lauren's upset, Jamie's upset. Interestingly, I've heard them both say that they feel bullied by the other one. I just think they should just hug it out. Hug it out over a nice glass of warm swamp water.
With all the infighting, they've not noticed that the water supply is dwindling to a standstill.
Realistically, the women need to drink about 3 litres of water a day. At the moment,
with only one jerry can,
they're averaging just one, and you can't sustain that.
Maybe a little drop more, darling.
Today, Jamie has managed to boil and filter the one remaining jerry can. But water is already running low.
Doesn't look very much to me.
No,
it's not much at all.
With not enough water to go round, Julie and Georgina take the last cup before leaving camp to go fishing.
There's only so much water in a jerry can, and it just so happens that you are the back of the queue because you're doing other things and you don't get to fill up your bottle, then there's barely any water left for you.
I've got a nice bit of tangled net here, which I'm going to try and get some crabs with.
Good, good.
Did you get your water?
It's, yeah, it's in here. Have you got yours?
Yeah.
Do you want to put it in there?
It's all right, I can manage it.
OK. Come on, fellas. Just even a little one.
It's exhausting, isn't it?
Yeah. Back in camp, Lauren and Becky are getting ready to hunt.
Very prepared, just in case.
We have no water to drink.
We're going to have to go, aren't we?
Yes, boss.
Lauren, Beth and Becky have to leave camp to hunt with nothing to drink.
Trying to look for food in around here is like trying to look for a needle in a haystack.
I definitely feel like Beyoncé in the Survivor video now. It's not as glamorous.
Bit humid in here, isn't it?
Hot, no water either. The best idea.
Without water, the heat is beating them, and the hunting party have no choice but to return to camp empty-handed.
Oh my God, that sun is hot.
Come on, fishies.
On the rocks, Julie and Georgina have now been fishing for 4 hours in 30-degree heat.
Oh, here's a box fish. Bugger off! Look at that!
Don't you go any further forward on that rule.
Oh dear, my head just went then.
Just sit down.
Oh dear me. I nearly hit the deck then, Julie.
Oh,
everything
man.
Went white.
Oh, fucking hell.
Do you mind if we make our way back? I just feel a bit rough.
I think the two of us have got sunstroke.
with their water intake now down to just 1 litre a day. The women don't know it, but they are chronically dehydrated. If they don't start upping their fluid intake immediately, their kidneys will struggle to cope, toxins build up in your body, and I reckon within days, their internal organs will shut down. And I'm not being dramatic about this. They're in a lot of trouble right now.
Oh my God. I've been out in the sun too long.
How are you doing, Jules?
Just exhausted, love. Every time we move, it's like to sit up, stand up, or sit down. You know, we go all, ooh. You know what I mean?
I feel like we've been stupid to sit out in the sun in that heat with not enough water in the middle of this, in the middle of the day. It's so frustrating. It's so frustrating because we could see all the fish there and we desperately wanted to.
I'm coming with you next time,
Bruce. Come back.
I'm too tired to even speak. I hate being like this. It's horrible. Not that I've the energy to do anything.
Yesterday, Julie and Georgina went fishing without enough water and collapsed from dehydration.
I can't stand this lack of strength in myself and lack of energy and inability to keep going all day because my body just won't let me.
Since discarding a contaminated jerry can and halving their water production, it's slowly dawning on the women that they're facing chronic dehydration.
There's just not enough water for everyone at the moment. We've all got pretty much empty bottles at the moment. So I now need to wait for this to get boiled, which is going to take a long time.
Right,
hon. What's that?
Water's just tipped over. Fuck.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Now we've got one shitty jerry can and it falls predictably. I knew it was going to fucking fall. By the time she's picked it up, all the water's fallen out. I'm not drinking enough. Nobody is.
I am feeling weak right now.
Are you?
I can't get up the sand. It's like an effort to walk. And it's so tiring. I don't know about you, Georgie, but I keep going lightheaded, do you?
Yeah, every time I bend over.
It's terrible.
That sounds really strange, but every time I sort of bend down when to do like something and then get back up, I get really dizzy. I think everyone's feeling the same, aren't they? I am really, really concerned about each of us not drinking enough. I mean, some people are drinking less than a litre a day. I think it's just got worse and worse and worse. Each of us is feeling like we're going to faint at several points during the day.
Having spotted the telltale signs of serious dehydration, Dr. Belinda calls an emergency meeting.
The biggest killer out here, our biggest highest risk, is dehydration.
We should be getting 2 litres to 4 litres a day.
If everyone has one small bottle when you wake up, then at least you're a quarter of the way there already.
Look, we are in scary territory where we just don't know what's happening to our bodies. And there could be effect on our vital organs as well. Your kidneys, and also your central nervous system. So if you experience any weird symptoms at all, do tell me. On that note, I just need a sample of your urine. It's going to give me a general idea of any alarming kidney problems.
Yay, thank you.
Belinda will send the samples to my support medical team on a nearby island.
So if any of us are in extreme danger, then what happens?
You'd be evacuated off. If there's any indication of serious damage to your kidneys, then we would need to look into that immediately.
And is it possible for us, some of us, to be in this state without knowing about it?
Yeah, because a lot of the symptoms mimic problems that we actually have. Tiredness is a big thing with kidney failure. Nausea as well. We could well be in this serious situation, be unaware of it.
It was quite alarming what she had to say, really, about the way that our bodies can start to fail.
I suppose I should have paid more attention to what was going to happen to my body. But I was surprised that I was potentially at such risk.
The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Oh, my God. Whose is that short one?
Georgina.
It's like Guinness.
Right.
To investigate their health further, Dr. Belinda also weighs the women.
115. Don't know what you were before.
I was 120.
We're quite fragile in a sense, and the fact is that the things that are kind of deteriorating in my body are my guns and my tits. If that continues, then I will probably end up being skeletal within about 2 or 3 weeks, and just kind of give up and just be like, do you know what? Let the fucking vultures peck at me.
I was 125.
Oh, so you've lost a lot, haven't you? You are 116.
I can't have lost 9 pounds.
You do look really, really thin.
Expected to lose a few pounds each week. Yeah. Not fucking 9 pounds. Bit of a fucking hike, isn't it? At that rate, I'm not. You're going to be fucking carrying me off on a stretcher. You know what I mean? So I'm so fucking tired.
You're tired because you never bloody stop.
Well, that's.
You're like a bloody Duracell bunny, Julie. You are.
The women may feel at rock bottom, but an instinct to stay alive really is deep within us all. You know, our subconscious wants us to survive and to thrive.
Well, let's have a little scavenge and see what we can find in this shit heap.
The group make a last-ditch attempt to produce more drinking water. Having discarded one of the jerrycans, Fee, Julie and the others forage for a second suitable container to boil water.
Oh, what's that there?
Basically just a load of shit. Nothing very useful, I don't think.
Metal is something that really is important. I haven't seen any. It's all plastic and you can't obviously boil them.
So, yes. If we don't get the things we need, we won't survive. It's as simple as that.
Plastic bottles, plastic cans, basically plastic. That's it. Oh, we don't want that.
They've failed to find any metal containers, but Julie is not giving up.
We have to find something.
Desperately dehydrated, she hunts further afield to find a second container.
What a tag. We'll be high again in a minute.
Julie! Julie! Oh, fucking hell, Jules. What's wrong?
I'm just so weak.
Get B and get on the blower!
No!
Julie! Julie!
It's day 35, and 55-year-old Julie has collapsed from dehydration.
Just so weak. So weak.
Get B and get on the blower!
No. George, no, don't ring anyone. I'll get out.
No, you won't. No, you won't. Just leave.
B, Julie's passed out.
Stay there, Jules. Stay there.
Yeah,
what's wrong? We've got a situation here in that Jules has passed out.
With Dr. Belinda away from camp collecting water and out of reach, my emergency medical team on a nearby island is immediately scrambled.
How are you feeling?
I think it was just...
It's all right, just precautionary, OK? What we want to do, Julie, how do you feel about trying to sit up for me? How's it feel? Just hold your pulse while you're sat up there.
Yeah.
What about drinking today?
I probably haven't had a lot today, to be honest.
You need to be constantly hydrated to do the smallest tasks here. And it really does go to show that just in one little moment here, it can all change.
Yeah. I'm happy you're bright enough. Everything's
honestly,
fine.
Honestly, go, please.
Okay.
so embarrassed.
Right, she's dehydrated. You're all dehydrated. If you can just keep an eye on her. You put a whole load of fit soldiers on iron like this for 2 weeks, and they'd struggle with it as well. No, definitely not again.
Oh, you're awful good to me.
I don't think I'm a drama queen. But I think I could have just closed my eyes and drifted off. And not come back.
Even the strongest women are slowly dying of thirst.
I might need to lie down again.
For nearly 5 weeks, the group has been subsisting on barely any food. And they remain down one jerry can, producing half the water they need to survive.
Basically, I think I either almost fainted or very briefly lost consciousness.
The signs of chronic dehydration really are now starting to show amongst women. And to give you an idea, just losing just 5% of your body weight in water leads to irritability, headaches, lightheadedness. When you get to 8%, the lack of water causes fainting fits. After that, delirium and hallucinations set in. And when you get to 15 to 20% of your body weight lost, you're dead.
It's literally just our minds now getting us through it. It's literally just people being like, I am going to finish this, I am going to finish this, that is keeping us going, like you yesterday.
No, it isn't, I'm not going home. So, not going home.
Exactly.
The group's on their arse at the minute, Georgie. The group is completely on their arse.
The results of everyone's emergency urine tests are back.
Foxtrot, Foxtrot, this is...
All 10 all together can hear you loud and clear. Over.
Paramedic Mike and survival expert Ross, my rapid response unit on a nearby island, have urgently asked to speak to the whole camp.
I'm looking at your urine results and things.
Yeah, and I'm looking at your weight charts and everything. And I'm looking at people whose kidney function is on a decline.
And I cannot stand by and let that decline continue. Based on the fact
that what I'm looking at and what I saw the other day
and your dietary input, it's
not enough to keep you going without causing you all, or certainly
a number of you, some long-term problems.
Your bodies are just starting to fail at this point.
Now, there's no easy way to say this.
I'm teetering right on the brink
of pulling you all off the island for medical reasons, over.
Bloody hell.
Yeah, I think everyone really understands, over.
The solution is...
use the other jerry can. I can't
say it any other way.
You need to be drinking, at a minimum,
3 litres of water per day.
Worst case scenario, when you're all sitting in a hospital,
the thought of drinking out of a
slightly disgusting jerry can that's had
pigs in it will not seem as bad as potentially a lifetime on dialysis.
Copy that.
If you do not get control
in 36 hours' time, you're coming off the island. Over.
There you go.
The women have just 36 hours to pull back from the brink.
They're not fucking about. We are going to be pulled off this island. I mean, very fucking seriously.
I know that we all need water, full stop, and that's the only thing that's going to stop our kidneys failing. Secondarily, let's get some regular food into us. That's going to help with our general energy levels.
For us to get to the end of this, it's about keeping our energy levels up and hydration levels up so that we actually survive for the next couple of days and don't go into renal failure. And if we don't, then we're going to be taken off and we're all going to look like massive dickheads.
I know some people are struggling more than others, but what we need to do is, you know, try and work together without causing arguments, disagreements, unnecessary stress.
think everyone's knackered, everyone is tired, everyone has no energy, hasn't eaten food, we're all in the same boat, but we all need to come together.
Exactly.
We have to get through it. We have to pull together. And in a way, it's going to force us to do that. At times, we work as individuals and not really work as a team, but we're going to have to. We have to work together now.
When a group faces a life-threatening crisis, do you lie down and die, or do you pick yourself up and determine that you're going to control your destiny? You're going to go out there, you're going to be resourceful, you're going to work hard, and you're going to turn the situation around. If these women have any hope of surviving, it means teamwork. And that takes courage and hard graft.
Right, Nick.
So I've got to cross that swamp.
Yeah. Okay.
With everyone agreed they need the crucial second jerry can, Fee has volunteered to retrieve and sanitise it so the women can immediately double their water intake.
That can is going to be full of all sorts of shit and bugs.
I'm not really breathing very deeply.
Rank with putrid pork, it's been sweltering in the swamp for 10 days.
Oh, nice. Splashed on my foot.
But sometimes the island can be unexpectedly generous.
Not that smelly, is it?
Absolutely amazing. It doesn't smell rank on any level.
Maybe the maggots have done the job.
There's a lot to be said for maggots. I'm so glad we got that jerry can back, actually.
Yay!
Now the two jerry can system is back up and running, the women should at last be able to hit the daily target of 3 litres of water each.
So we've got one can on the boil.
And I just want to get this one filtered. Well, I'm less stressed now about the water. Just drink that anyway, shut up.
Get it down, you.
I'll just squeeze away out.
Thank God, it's so sweet.
But I don't want to, I'm not leaving. We've
been walking too long before we find some yucca.
With the water production line back on a roll, Jamie is happy to return to work, joining forces with Lauren and Beth to find carbohydrates the group urgently needs.
God, I can barely walk.
It's really hard. It's hard, you know, being in a group and put under so much stress, and nobody's perfect. Everybody has their moments, but we have to stick together as a team.
Our muscles are stronger.
Oh, I can see some yucca.
Bring what back. You got there?
Woo! Once you see one, you see them all.
Oh, my. Hello. Small, but perfectly formed.
Uh-oh, Lauren, as always. The girls got yucca.
Yeah, we got yucca.
Woo!
Yeah. That's amazing, Lauren.
Well, yeah, Lauren. Lauren.
Yes.
Well,
not just me. High five, Pepper.
Yay.
Yay.
Oh. Way. Check out my yucca.
Jack, a piece of my yucca. In and around all. Please, you're right on the edge. It's freaking me out.
It's all right, love.
Wow.
A rehydrated Julie is with Georgie and Beth, determined to finally land that elusive fish for supper.
Okay, another little fishy.
And they've come up with a new way to attract fish, a sparkling lure.
And that is a state-of-the-art bit of fishing kit there.
Fishing tackle.
Right. Coca-Cola, give us some luck.
If I get pulled in, I'm going to swim round that way.
You won't.
I'm so cack-handed at everything. Oh! I can see, like... Oh! Oh!
As hard as you can.
Oh!
Oh, my God! I can't believe it!
Dinner.
Basically, whatever it takes to stay, whatever it takes.
Go on, Jules, persuade that fisherman to give us some fish.
Hola! Hola!
He's coming.
Not content with just one small fish, Julie spots another opportunity. The first passing boat the women have seen in these waters.
Don't know, Jules, it's your turn to get the baps out.
He's not going to want to see a 55-year-old's baps.
I don't know, mate, your baps are way better than mine.
You have fish?
Get a fish.
One fish?
Fish.
We
fish.
Have none. We have none. No fish.
He's going to throw it.
Oh, you're very, very kind. Whoa! Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bless you. Bless you. Good luck.
Gracias, amigo. Now, I think that is a...
barracuda. I could just go... and bite it and eat it raw. I'm so hungry.
I don't know whether that was actually the playing by Queensbury rules, but innovation, innovation, innovation.
Woo! We caught a fish!
Yeah!
Oh my god, it's massive! Woo! This is about you, barracuda. Barracuda. Yeah!
Oh my god, you're
incredible.
Smells amazing. We should have got this place licked. You know, 10 women, hey, this place should have been shipshape. Tragically, not the case.
That's the hero of the moment.
I don't even want to talk. It's so tasty. But at least we've started now. Not too late.
Next Wednesday on the Men's Island.
It's little old me.
Unfortunately, I don't trust you.
Whoa! It's a death trap around here.
Snake!
We have no food.
Stop it!
Holy shit!
Next week, we're back with both islands, Wednesday and Thursday at 9. Tomorrow, Jeremy Paxman, David Mitchell and a comedy pack bring it to the results with Channel 4's Alternative Election Night from 9 live. But coming up, the campaigning is now in the bag. Ballot Monkey's election comedy concludes next.